No doubt about it. It's been a tough time for people in our area in the aftermath of Hurricane Sandy.
A lot of people are coping with losses and the tragic devastation that the storm left behind.
Family therapist Dr. Paul Hochmeyer is with us this morning. He has some ways to deal with post-hurricane stress. Doc, nice to have you here.
Thank you.
What are you seeing in your practice?
Well, basically, we see that there's a lot of physical damage that's come out of the hurricane. There's also a lot of emotional damage that's more subtle that we really need to take a look for. The three things that I see my patients coming with me are sadness. They're profoundly sad over what happened, regardless of whether or not they personally have sustained any damage, but we see it all around us. They're very anxious. Hurricanes, by their very nature, really uproot our lives in many different ways, and that causes our anxiety to raise. The other thing is that I see is people are very angry and mad.
We often think of post-traumatic stress disorder as a military thing, but are people suffering from that after a storm like this? Some people?
Absolutely. It depends. Post-traumatic stress is based on trauma. And events like this, where we're uprooted from our lives, where we're subject to forces of nature, which are profound, really can be very traumatic for a lot of people.
And, you know, with this other storm coming in, I did have friends of mine who say, you know, they're worried, they're anxious again. What can we do to kind of relieve that at the moment?
Well, the first thing we need to do is make sure that we follow a routine. It's very important. Even if it's as simple as setting our alarm in the morning and getting up at a specific time and making our bed. It sounds very simple, but it's something that we can do to maintain control over our lives. The other thing is we can do is we can manage the amount of exposure that we have to a lot of these images. And the third thing that we can do is one of the things that I saw really coming up here on the subway is being kind to one another and making life better for each other.
We see we put up these things, spend time with others, avoid troubling storm images, take care of your own health, be grateful. Be grateful. Right. You have to think about that every morning.
There are a lot of, how do these symptoms mask themselves? Overeating, undereating, insomnia, being lethargic. What are those telltales that we should be watching for, either in ourselves or our loved ones?
Well, the first thing is how we're going to manage the stress that happens. And typically what we do is we reach for something outside of ourselves to manage it. The easiest thing to do is food, and in particular junk food. So we need to be very mindful about the kinds of foods that we're putting into our bodies. We also need to make sure of taking a look at, are we really irritable? Are we really sleepy? Is everything an effort? Do we feel very ungrounded in the world? So these are the things that we need to be on the lookout for so we can take some steps to reground ourselves.
A friend of mine who is a reporter, she was in a dangerous situation. She got out of the dangerous situation and then was in a blackout. Mm. And she said to me, in the middle of the blackout, she remembered that she left Pop-Tarts on her bed.
Sure.
And in the dark, she searched for the Pop-Tarts and sat on the bed and ate them. That obviously is a psychological problem. Although
right.
I have to say I was eating a lot of junk food the last few days too out of nervousness.
Right. Well, food is incredibly comforting, and it's something that we can grab for. And so the Pop-Tarts probably reminded her of being comforted as a child and having somebody comfort her. So we associate a lot of that with food, and food is love, food is comfort. It's all of those things.
As we wrap, would you say probably the most important thing which can be helpful as we recover is a sense of community?
Absolutely. You know, I was coming up here on the subway, I was seeing young men stand up and give their seats to older women, and that to me is a sense of community, and that's the real spirit of New York.
All right, Dr. Hochmeyer, so nice to have you here on Good
Thank
Day
you.
New York. Great advice.
Pleasure.
We appreciate you being here.